Apparently, Bonnie's got a theory.
You remember the Prince song, When Doves Cry?
When the doves start crying?
Yeah. All right, here we go. No, here. Okay, let's...
This is what it sounds like when the doves cry.
What Bonnie has insisted for 15 years is him setting up, I'm about to do my impression of doves crying. Listen, here's how it goes. And then he does.
This is like the entire song is this beautiful poetic illustration of this unlistenable sound. No, but for real.
Oh, let's start this train wreck. Hello, you beautiful citizens of the internet. It is Tuesday night, and you know what that means, you beautiful demon hordes. It is go time for the show dedicated to the best shit on the internet since the start of the world. I'm Brian Rushwood, live in Austin, Texas. Joining me is OAKA, it's JRY. What's going on, Justin?
Man, I don't know, dude. It's been a fun week. I can't believe that Bonnie really did feel that when doves cry.
I mean, look, this could be the next 2 hours because we like she's
already been.
She's still.
I'm still not over it. Like there's already been the cartoon made of how long ago we talked about that. But yeah, no, that's pretty crazy.
The best, what the audio listeners missed is that the cartoon just shows Bonnie emoting, like gesturing at the record. Yeah. Like
you hear it, right?
The evidence speaks for itself, right? It is pretty great that I'm playing off of my hair as well.
Yes, that's so funny.
Hey, man, how you been, Justin?
Oh, dude, it's been pretty good, pretty good. A little hectic, man. I'm going back to my college over the weekend.
Why would you do that?
I'm back to school. Rodney Dangerfield movie all over again.
Yeah. It's like, well, I gave a sizable contribution because my son is having trouble with the ladies and I got to show him how to party. You know how it goes.
No, I'm speaking at like an alumni thing for the paper that I went to, and it's gonna be a fun time. It's really just me getting to meet back up with a bunch of old friends and everything, but it means I got to get a lot of stuff done before I go be intensely irresponsible in the place where like now it's like it's more appropriate that I'm trying to relive my college days here because it's where I live my college days.
Hang on, I personally. Stop me if you've heard this before. I would be crippled with fear about what I would say or do in that situation. But you seem unaffected by it.
Amongst other like people that you went to college with, current college students.
Yeah, wait. Are you doing a thing with your old college buddies or for the young crop to inspire them and be like a shining example of how rad you are?
Well, the event is there, organized by the newspaper that I used to work at. Now they're bringing back alumni people as they do every spring, to talk to the youth, the current staff, I guess.
See, and that doesn't intimidate you? You're just gonna, what are you gonna talk about?
So wait,
to me, it would be like if they invited me to talk to, let's say, yeah, I did the Plan 2 program at UT, right? Which is a kind of super exclusive small group. But like I would feel like, oh, shit, man, I have to definitely come across as somebody who's a super successful guy. And so like I would just say poop and then screw it all up.
So you would be worried that you would not project enough success?
Yeah, or if I did so, it would be in a self-aggrandize. It's a freaking Chinese finger trap. You can't project success because you come across as a neurotic, insecure asshole. Yeah, you can't just be sincere because everyone will go to sleep and not believe you that you're worth anything.
I mean, I don't know. I feel like number one, Merman 1983 in the Twitch chat just says, "Do weed jokes? The kids love weed jokes."
Yes, and you should probably have some content in there as well.
Well, I don't know though, because so here's why I don't feel any pressure. It's because I'm the black sheep of the family of people that have come out of this newspaper. The other people that have come out of this newspaper, another person that I used to work with that's on this panel was nominated for a Pulitzer Prize. The other one has worked for the intervening, you know, damn near 15 years at a newspaper as a – he is now a well-respected arts reporter in the Buffalo area. So for me – I'm not going to be as good as them, so I might as well just be like show up, you know, on a Rascal scooter with a cigarette hanging out of my mouth, like with beer cans falling off of it. Like I might as well just be the ridiculous
smoking
person.
Right out of the ventilator in your chest. Like
I'm smoking out of the hole in my throat. Anyway.
Oh jeez. You know,
shit happens when you party naked. Like.
No, that's a pretty good play. Like, if you can make it self-deprecating and talking about how successful everyone else is and then laughingly say one of us is a podcast host, then, you know.
I think that's it. But what you should really do. I was seriously thinking about showing up drunk. I because it's an early morning thing. It'd be funny if I had a flask on me. I feel like that's what I owe it because – anytime that I used to go to these things when I was working there, like it was always so boring.
Time out. Right now, what do you think the expression on Bonnie's face is?
Oh, horrified.
Bonnie's face is that puppet from that Vegas show, the old man puppet.
from the Terry Fader show?
Yeah, Terry McFader's, but only like he sucked on 12 lemons and is folded in on itself.
So, hey, Bonnie, are you arguing against me showing up drunk to this panel where I speak to the youth?
Yes! I really hate when, because there's a real mythos too, like, oh, yeah, you gotta get drunk to be a writer, because, like, Hemingway and other people. Mm. But, like, so, no, don't make
all... like, you know, Hemingway... also all writers, including friends of ours, who recently talked about how shitty their writing got once they stopped drinking while they did it.
But wait, all right, no, but like put yourself in the position of the kids that are there. Isn't it better if I give the exact same advice that I would have otherwise, but I'm just a little drunk?
Okay, first of all.
If you're good.
And I say I'm drunk. I have to say I'm drunk. Like, if I don't say I'm drunk, then I just have a problem. If I'm say I'm drunk, it's performance art.
I say you're drunk and not be drunk.
Right. I would say the theatrical conceit of busting out a flask midway or setting up a running gag where it's like, listen, I made a promise to myself that I was going to punish myself every time I... self-aggrandized or whatever, set up whatever the structure is and then let that be the way to punctuate everything during the speech is, you know, and then you have the awkward moment where maybe
so it
you
is
stop.
Just me doing a panel. I'm not giving a speech. I'm not like bringing notes or examples or anything.
All right, hold on. This just changed
panel
everything.
On like what to take from your newspaper career and like I'm the dude who sits in front of his camera and
so in
talk.
Other words, you're saying you want to print out a bunch of Dharma Initiative non-alcoholic beverage labels.
I mean, listen, all I'm saying is I've done a lot more like just big crowd pleasing panels drunk than I've done sober, right? Like if we're making that bar graph, there is one gigantic skyscraper.
It is,
and one
okay,
charming
all right, hold on.
Hamlet.
That visual is pretty punk rock. If you show up with a knapsack and just at appropriate moments, just pop out the Coors Light and just pop it and then listen like, oh, no, go on. Explain to me your theory. You know, like if you bust out the Kermit sipping tea kind of aesthetic, that could work.
I feel like that's going to be the way to go because also it's like otherwise, like, who cares? I do podcasts. If you want to talk to me, you can email me. I'll give you all the details and there'll be numbers in it and stuff like that. But for right then. For some mandatory panel for the staff, like, whatever. Might as well bring a little levity to it and not pretend like, well, I don't know. When I'm making cum jokes, I really want to make sure that, you know, I remember that advertiser-friendly is a blah, 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 CPMs. Like, who gives a fuck?
Mike TV in the chat is just, like, he just wants you to burn it down, says bust out a foghorn and just keep chirping it whenever you don't like what you're hearing.
I just want to say,
I'll tell you what, considering how argumentative I was in my formative years, I feel like that would just bring PTSD back to the other two people that actually worked with me if I was just constantly interrupting them with loud noises.
I just want to say that I think you're very talented and you don't need to be drunk for this.
Hmm. Okay. All right. I don't think that it's necessarily me thinking that I need to do it.
Okay,
it's
no,
not
okay.
Augmenting,
you know what?
My personality.
Hold on. Hold on. I think what Bonnie's saying is that you should be more creative. You should not limit yourself to just drinking. You should have a knapsack, go a little carrot top here. Like, first you bust out a beer and you pop it. Then later you bust out a flask. Then you pull out a copy of Penthouse with a centerfold. Then you light a doobie. And then at some point you start cutting powder and you make a line and you just snort it. Then you start choking yourself and jerking off.
Here's
in
Brian. Here's a new character.
No. Okay.
Here's a new character idea. Casual heroin joke guy.
The all set up prop comedian.
That's it. I keep bringing out drugs and drinks.
Well, and you have a trunk. You have a trunk. Very prominent.
A Gallagher
on stage,
trunk.
But you never, and you always say, you always talk about like, oh, I was thinking on the flight back. You ever notice how? And you keep doing all the ever notice hows, and you keep leaning like you're about to open the trunk, and then instead it just ends with like, okay. And then you're done.
I just like the idea of just like Gallagher or Carrot Top only doing like drug jokes. Like, he just walks up to somebody on stage. Hey, do you like Pepsi? I prefer Coke. And just throws a bunch of Coke in their face. Like,
but it's actual cocaine.
It's actual Coke.
And the guy goes, I didn't consent to this. What's happening?
Come to Carrot Top's edgy new act. Warning, you might get dosed. People are like lifting up the plastic in front of their faces.
That's pretty good. I love the idea of him just smashing bricks of cocaine and everybody getting wicked high on it.
That's it. He's just got gigantic bricks of weed and he's just like, meh. And then at one point he just injects himself with heroin and there's no joke and it's very dramatically lit. And this is what it sounds like when doves cry.
Dude, it's going to be a great bit. I'm sure it's going to go great.
Wait, Bonnie, you would think less of me if I did it, that I would be hiding from my true self?
Bonnie feels like you're just working blue and you don't need to.
You don't need to. And I would like you to step up into
out of my dreams and get into
my
car.
Car.
Is what she's
trying to say. Yeah, for Knight Rider.
For a Knight Rider.
Light
me on fire.
A lot of metaphors right
so
now.
We can drive away. I think it's pretty clear.
I think you're just being like, you're not taking your place and your
legacy.
I should
bring some more decorum that maybe like this is a way to say, hey, no, to all these kids, independent media is a thing, a future that you can dream of. And here is an example to do it instead of just shambling in like some sort of alcoholic mess.
I disagree. I think it's
but that's
punk
not
rock.
As funny on
think,
Night Attack.
I think it's
I mean, tomato, tomato, right?
It's the equipment. I mean, you got to time it. Right, you can't just show up with your prop in hand. You got to make a moment out of it. Like, that's what made Piff the Magic Dragon's entire career, was that punk rock moment where he just busted out a banana, like, cool story, bro, as he was being judged. He flipped that whole dynamic on its ear, and you could probably do something like that.
I don't know. I mean, like, I don't know. Maybe I am alcoholic. Ever think about that? Huh?
Hey, do we want to talk about our idea that we're teasing? Maybe we're going to try this in the after show, but.
Our new challenge?
No. Our new advice program.
There were a bunch of people that came over on Friday. My personal channel, twitch.tv/JustinRYoung, which is where I stream all my one mic stuff, got partnered. late last week.
Which, by the way, means free money. Like, if you are an Amazon Prime subscriber, you have 5 magical free dollars that all you have to do is say out loud, I want Justin Robert Young to have it. Or you can wait until Nine Attack gets partnered and maybe do that. That's it. But I'm just saying, you have magic
whatever
free
money.
Whatever
you want to do. You can do what you want, I right?
mean, either way. It is a big accomplishment. It's a big deal.
And if you I did a little celebration stream, and it was just a piano bar. It was just name me things that you like, topics that you want me to talk about, impressions, characters, whatever. Of course, Captain Morgan comes up at a certain point, and we did just questions to Captain Morgan, and it went really, really well. Bryce was there, and
I remember this.
Wait, Bryce?
Yeah.
Did you have something?
This is great. No, this is a great idea, and I'm excited to hear what this is.
I mean, it should just be an advice program, right? Super short.
The idea was to basically, just do Dan Savage's Savage Love podcast, but with Captain Morgan. So it would just be a call in. You would leave a message, a voice message, and Captain Morgan would respond to it. And I think we might we might try that a little bit later tonight.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Should Justin do the whole panel as the ad dragon, currently at 100% votes, show up drunk, get drunk at 0 votes, stay sober, 0 votes, show up as Captain Morgan coming from behind?
He always does, huh?
There's only one move.
Or a pole pot.
Or a pole pot. Yeah, so I don't know. So I think...
That's fun.
You know, I don't know. It went pretty well. So I think we might try it as a call-in show during the after show, which, of course, you can get if you are a patron by going to patreon.com/nightattack. Now, of course, all of our pre-shows and after shows are always free. They will always be free. But they come to you early, priority style, if you are a patron. So go on over, patreon.com/nightattack. Kick us a few shekels if you got them clanking around in your pocket. And we appreciate everybody who makes this show a priority. Because I'll tell you what, folks, pays the bills around here.
All right. I don't normally do this. But I'm pandering to a last-minute pledger who just more than doubled his pledge.
Brian, that's a hell of a setup for the...
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Night Attack new Patreon name chant corner hour.
It's an hour of it. All right, I need a judge's ruling on whether or not this is even a real name. And I need you to tell me what he's doing when he's surprised to hear his name, Andrew Balls.
Oh, Andrew Balls?
Yeah.
Andrew Balls.
B-A-H-L-S.
Is running for mayor.
Of what? Of what town?
Of Old Cindertown.
Old Cinderton.
Kentucky.
Old Cinderton, Kentucky.
And he's signing his name on the final sign-off for his signs, his ball signs that are going to go out on yards all over Cindertown. Well, and he is...
Everybody's wearing pins that say, I'm a baller, B-A-H-L-E-R, right?
And then there's some rejected T-shirts that are just saying, I have balls, right? Just right on the front.
And then there's that one annoying guy who keeps saying, I dip my Andrew in it. Remember that reference from the state 20 years ago? No? Jesus. Okay. I'll see myself out.
But anyway, he's hearing in his ear, Andrew Balls.
Wherever you are. Whatever political debate you're currently having right now, know that you are our most beloved patron, because we're dead now and we're ghosts. We're going to haunt your
career.
Are
you not even going to say the name? You just have to say the name.
What?
You have to say the name.
Andrew Balls.
Andrew Balls.
Andrew Balls. Hopefully this was weird for you.
Andrew Balls.
You know what? I wonder if you could pronounce his name to make it sound like the end of a line. Like, and Drew balls.
What's the end of the line?
The beginning of the line is...
I was playing an anatomy card game and drew balls.
There you go. And drew balls. He's like, all right, Drew, Jason, you guys, you are going to be Stickman and Drew balls. I don't know. I'm trying.
Stacy fails and Drew balls.
There it is.
Also, he's in the chat. It says it's pronounced like Bales, but that's...
Yeah. All right, one more time, you guys. From the top.
And Drew Bales.
You, too, can have us make a mockery of your name by joining us over at patreon.com. And
Brian Bushwood.
Yeah, goddammit.
Brian Bushwood.
Brian brushes his wood. The warehouse.
God, you gotta stop it.
Do a fine gleam.
Do a fine gleam. Hey, man. So here's the thing is when you become a patron, you get your very own feed on your podcast app. You just use that feed and it gets the entire pre-show, post-show, everything in 1 3.5 hour rock block, give or take. No promises on length. Take it from me, Brian Brushwood. Length doesn't matter.
This is a new level of weird self-depreciation.
So let's
Brian's hey. Like the studio cut of a movie. You know, a lot of people like it shorter.
Hey, speaking of snakes on a train, let's let's.
Hey, how about this? Something that we want to start doing because he deserves more recognition on this show is recognize the work of Stephen Cogswell. He's an amazing song crafter. He winds up making these amazing songs based on the episodes that we do. He's been doing them weekly for a very, very, very long time.
Dude,
everybody should go and
give him
check
the spotlight.
Out his work.
Give him that spotlight for Night Shark Attack.
So this one is at otfi.com/shark. Yeah, here we go.
Dear my dearest Bonnie, tonight I gazed upon the one eye of glory. Its brown countenance descended upon me, and I transcended to a higher plane. I hope ere this tweet reaches you this late evening.
Like the Pharaoh's final glance, I have seen a cat's asshole.
Sounds legit.
All right.
Yeah, in hindsight, maybe we shouldn't have spent 30 minutes drawing cats' assholes.
Mommy shark, doo 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 doo. Mommy shark, doo 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 doo. Mommy shark, doo 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 doo. Mommy shark. Don't know what you're talking about, doo 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 doo. Don't know what you're saying, doo 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 doo. Don't know what you mean, doo 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 doo.
I'm immune to bad rhythm. I'm a bad run to bad meter. I'm good.
Talking about do 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 do. Don't know what you're saying. Do 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 do. Don't know what you mean. Do 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 do.
I'm immune to bad rhythm. I'm a bad run to bad meter. I'm good.
Fuck you, Schwartz. Do 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 do. Fuck you, Schwartz. Do 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 do. Fuck you, Schwartz. Do 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 do. Fuck you, Schwartz. I said good day. Do 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 do.
Poorly written, catchy tune was what they were apologizing for.
He's Cogswell, man, a genius. A genius in his own time.
Men.
Everybody, awtfy.com.
If you're looking for an shark. Easy way to remember, it's, and with that, fuck you.
.com. But just the letters.
Just that it's a reverse palindrome acronym.
Although, you could probably get, and with that, fuck you.com.
Yeah, but that's a lot to write. So instead, just do a-otfy.
Otfy.
Otfy.
Otfie, bring me my robe.
He actually does own endwiththatfuckyou.com. So.
Hey, look at that. So go ahead. Type that if you ain't into this whole brevity
also,
thing.
If you're a manservant whose name is Otfie, please join us at the Brushwood compound because I would love it. Otfie! Otfie! Bring, 5 slippers. Don't ask why.
All right, hold on. Here, we're going to do real quick a voice workshop.
Dirty by giving me the disappointed look for 5 slippers because she could only think of one thing I would want 5 slippers for.
A quick trip to the warehouse. All the slippers like on his person.
Feel it out doing donuts.
Aviator shades on.
Otfie! You learn to drive a stick.
It's me, Otfie.
Otfie.
I'm here. Your slippers.
Otfie, I got so confused. I was watching Matlock. Have you seen the Matlock?
You've awoken me from my slumber. It's the slumber of Otfie.
Back in the coffin, Otfie. I don't need you now.
Yes, right away.
All right. Otfie.
Sorry.
Yes.
Go back to sleep.
I didn't go to sleep. I was just lying here with my eyes closed.
I just didn't know where the Keurig was, but I found it, and I see that you have the decaf.
It's right over. It's next to you.
Yeah. Yes.
It's next to you.
No, I noticed. Otfie.
Just reach your hand left.
It's fine.
Just
reach. It's fine. Otfie.
Is it good?
We're good. We're good. Good night, Otfie.
Turn on.
Good night,
turn
Otfie.
It on in front of me.
Good night, Otfie.
This good night. Has turned into Lauren Michaels. I don't know how.
Good night.
Anyway, I'm gone. Bye.
He's turned into the guy from Magnum P.I. Who is the guy? The rich guy.
Higgins?
Higgins, yeah. Higgins. Sorry. Hey, man. We got a game to play.
We do. Bryce, what is the game?
That's right. This is the shitty quick start. Sorry.
Otfie! He's done it again. He fucked up the name of the bit. I don't know. How do you program him to say it correctly?
Do you want me to do the bit, sir? Do you want me? I can say.
Otfie, I think.
Sure? It's no bother. I'm just in the coffin. It's no bother.
He says it's fine. Just stay in the coffin.
Is it okay?
Good night, Otfie. Good night. Yes, we're good.
It's Kickstarter, not quick starter. Kickstarter. Yes. Hard K.
Thank you, Otfie.
Thank you, Otfie. Yeah,
okay,
this is...
I'm going to go to sleep.
Good night, Otfie.
There we go. This is the shitty Kickstarter quiz. This is a creation from Waffleophagus and Curtis LaRock, who came up with this idea about a year ago. They found this subreddit called
Real quick, Bad Weave insists in the chat that you should just do Otfie the entire quiz.
Just no setup. I just show up with people that I haven't seen for 10 years.
You show up and you set up a coffin.
Should I do the show? Should I... Is it still on? Is it still on? I'm Otfie.
Everybody's like, what is Otfie a vampire or something? Sorry, you were saying.
Sorry, this is
technically I'm just undead, not a vampire. I was not bitten by anything. I'm just an undead man.
Otfie, we're doing the quiz. Otfie, just please. You can just.
I was just clearing it up. I heard. I was about to go to sleep. I just picked it up.
Yeah, no, Otfie. I know.
Is everything good?
Yes, it's great.
Did
Otfie.
You fix the Keurig?
Yes. No. In fact, I was able to get 2 cups out of this one. It worked out great.
Great.
Would you like one? I can make you one, Otfie.
No. I'm going to sleep.
Okay, all right. Good night. Bye. What I love is the idea that it's not actually a squeaky coffin.
It's him making the noise.
Makes that sound.
Okay. So this is the.
Oh yeah, we're doing a game.
We're doing a game.
What's the game called, Bryce?
This is the shitty Kickstarter quiz.
Nailed it! I'm so proud of you.
You did great, Otfi. Otfi, we're doing the bit now. Okay.
Thank God. So I'm going to give you information, or we're going to watch a video about a crappy Kickstarter. A lot of these came from shittykickstarters.reddit.com. And the two things that each of you are going to guess per round is what they were asking for in terms of the goal and what they received. And we're not playing – we're playing closest, not Price is Right rules.
All right, got it.
This is that.
No game theory. No game theory. To mess it all up. Got it.
It's pure merit. So for this first one, I'm going to show you this video. You guys just tell me when you think you got an idea what this thing is. Huh?
Okay. All right.
But you have to describe what.
Yeah, we're seeing a cityscape. Looks like maybe an opening, establishing shot for emotional inception.
We see a guy and a girl.
It's sad people, though. They look very, very sad.
And isolated and alone, and they both have the same wristwatch, which is weird. Oh, but now the watch says the word now, and they're happy.
Now they're happy.
Color has returned to the world.
Well, but not enough color to make you feel like anything has substantially changed. And it just says...
Wait, that's the end of the video?
Wait, stop,
oh.
Stop,
oh,
pause.
Jesus,
pause
Christ!
It. Now it says, now watch. And I don't know if it's called the Now Watch.
It is called the Now Watch.
Okay.
Remind yourself of the most important time in your life, the time that makes or breaks you, the now. Here is our precious reminder.
I swear to God, if this is a watch that literally just says now.
It is a watch that just says now.
What the?
We're looking at a pretty crappy runaround. They made that really nice video for like 1 minute, and all of
the case material steel. it looks like a novelty that a crane game would jip you out of.
Okay, so hold on. It's horrible. Does this just
accuracy
like, immediately read that they spent a bunch of money on an
most
actual
accurate watch on Earth? It says.
Because it's always right now.
It is. It is right now. I'm sorry. You're saying, Justin.
It just. Oh my God.
They've got an infographic here. The past. Well, this is, that's depressed. The future. That's anxious. But the present. That's conscious.
Okay.
This has to be a postmodern referential joke. I'm gonna say.
Did that video scream postmodern referential?
No, half of it did. Okay, the first half of it screamed, we're actually trying. The second half of it screamed, this is all a joke. And they're even laughing as they...
Well, they started off with a blooper so that you know there's some levity in this.
So you know that they're human.
Right. Take two.
No, I don't know, man. I think that these guys are... I think that there's certainly a humorous element to them. But I know for a fact that there is a market for this product in the region that I live, in the Bay Area.
I'm going to say they're asking for $1 million because it's a joke. And I'm going to say they've gotten
$38.23. $38.23. All right, Juice, what do you think?
I think that they were asking for $5,000 and they got $300.
And they got $300.
Yeah.
All right. Well, this is the Now Watch. Remind yourself the most important time in your life, the time that makes or breaks you. The now. Here's our precious reminder. They were asking for in American dollars $8,273.
Oh wow.
They received $666, and on both accounts. Both accounts.
You ran away with it, Justin. Well done.
Nice. Nailed it. Oh, man. I'm already feeling this game.
This is...
Don't worry, Brian. You'll get the next one.
Thank you, Otfi.
All right. You've seen those on YouTube. You see those red hot knife videos?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
The glowing
red knife,
you know? And it's always a phone or a bottle.
Or a piece of ice
or an ad for
Christian heretic.
Sure.
It's like what will a hot knife do to this guy.
Your heresy will be pured by this
by this clarifying fire.
Oddfee! I learned this on the 700 Club.
So let's take a look at this clip here. So,
do they do it with a brand new car? Let's check it out. So I checked it and sadly it was mostly clickbait. They didn't confront the glowing knife.
Number one, what we're seeing is an astonishing number of fake YouTube videos that claim to cut through a car.
Yeah.
But I guess he was disappointed that nobody's actually taken a glowing hot knife and cut it through a car.
This is a Kickstarter?
This is a Kickstarter. Here, I'm gonna read this. In the last few months, we witnessed the emergence of many quote-unquote experimental videos featuring red-hot 1,000 degrees glowing knife. They are so popular, yet they failed to step up the game. So here I am, trying to combine our resources to make this project a confrontation of the mentioned knife and brand new car. That's right. He wants to buy a brand new car because all of the videos on YouTube are using used cars.
Oh, so there actually are them.
They are them.
Against, boy.
So we're going to start with Justin.
How much is he asking for?
Yeah, no, it's you first this time.
It's Justin this time.
Oh, is it me? Okay. I think he is asking for $100,000. Mm-hmm. And I think he got
$100.
$100, all right.
I think he is asking for much less. I think he actually wants to do this. So I'm going to say closer to $38,000.
Okay.
And I think he's gotten, I think he has enough of a fan base. No. I think he has enough of a fan base that he got closer to $500.
To $500. All right.
Moving on up, moving on up.
The glowing knife versus brand new car. I am making a video starring a confrontation of red hot glowing knife and brand new car. Earned $53.08 out of the asked $10,587 on. So that means Justin is closer on the get.
Yep.
Brian is closer on the ask.
All right. 3-1. 3-1.
3-1.
Nice.
You're doing well.
Pretty good.
Oddfee. He's winning.
Yes.
He's winning.
Yes.
I need
I'm
better.
I'm not asleep yet. If you were worried that you'd wake me, I wasn't asleep.
Okay. I'm playing with Justin. We're playing a game.
Great.
No, I would like advice. Are you sure you don't want to watch?
I'm about to go to sleep, but well, I'm here for you. Maybe, Captain Morgan.
Maybe start up the Diamond Club app on your iOS device, and you can just kind of have it on, and if you have advice, you can join in.
Oh, sure, I'll do that. Rich media characters. It's a great idea, Master Brushwood.
Thank you. All right.
All right, I'm going to... Anything else?
No. Yeah, you've done quite well, Oddfee. Great job as always.
Are you hungry?
I mean,
do you want a little snack?
I mean, if you're asking,
just a little, feeling a bit peckish.
Two pieces
just
of bacon.
A little snackaroo.
Yeah, 2 pieces of bacon with light brown sugar coating would be delightful. I mean, if you're not busy.
I'm not sleeping, if that's what you were worried about.
No, it's not happening.
Not with me. I don't want to intrude.
I know your coffin time
I'm
is
not,
very valuable.
No, don't worry. It's no bother to me. Adfee, the undead personal manservant of the Brushwood family. Okay. Of course not. I'm just going to get on out of here and start cooking some bacon.
Well, I mean,
follows
as long as you're up.
Out to the kitchen.
As long as you're up, some hot chocolate would be delightful as well.
Absolutely. This is great. I love my life. I'm undead.
If you could make sure to Irish it up as we, you know, discussed, wink. All right. We're going to play the game, Oddfee.
I'm getting it to you right now.
So
there's the milkshake and the bacon. Right. I'm going to go back to sleep now.
Let's go. Okay. It's fine.
Did anything else? I mean, just anything. I mean, you can just tell me anything. I'm undead. I was about to go to sleep, but now I'm not.
It's fine. It's fine.
Are you sure?
No. It's, I mean,
anything for you. That's what I say. I have it written here right in the coffin that I was about to sleep in.
No. I'm, it, you know.
Hey, that's not the Brian I know. The Brian I know speaks his mind.
I mean, last time you put both the brown sugar and you did a light dusting of powdered sugar on the bacon bits.
Say
I just...
no more. You put the brown sugar first and then the regular sugar next, because I am Matt Fee and I'm dead and I was certainly not going to sleep. Anyway, here you go, Master Brushwood.
Okay, we're
going
to go. We're going back to play our internet game.
I'm going to sleep. Don't bother. This is not awkward.
Luck.
Bye.
Okay, good night. You did wish me luck. It's fine. Not feet.
Okay, he's gone. All right.
That man is so nice.
he's one of the good ones. One of the better. Undead.
You should have got me bacon too.
Coffin-dwelling manservants that we've had around this house.
I wanted some bacon too, though.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's why I asked her too.
Really, Mistress Brushwood? I'm right out. Don't
no,
worry.
No,
don't
go to bed, Auntie. Go to bed. It's fine.
Are you sure?
It's fine.
It's no bother. I'm just
it's
here.
No, Auntie, that's why I asked.
I was on one way to dreamland, and then I was just.
That's why I asked for two, is for one for each of us. We're good. We're good.
Oh, thank you, Elf.
That's fine though. No judgment.
Also, okay. Good night.
Okay, there it is. All right, I'm gonna show you a very short video. See if you can tell me what this thing is.
I think that is a pro bottle flipping bottle. I think that the bottle flip challenge, which has had its own moment in the sun, has now sponsored. A some kind of what they hope to be a regulation bottle that that could provide accurate bottle flipping skills.
This is the Rev Bottle Pro Bottle Flipping. Rev Bottle is built for extreme bottle flipping battles, tournaments, and trick shots. With its aerodynamic features and dent resistant technology, the Rev Bottle.
The dent resistant technology is a fancy deal. Word for plastic.
But I mean, look at it. It has a dynamic challenge line. It has grip technology and dent resistant technology.
It's a fucking plastic bottle.
It is, but it's got a line on it, so you know where to appropriately fill the water.
Why do we do this, right?
It promotes hand-eye coordination, Bryce.
It promotes lessons in physics.
And athleticism and mobility.
Hey, it burns calories, guys.
It encourages sportsmanship.
Well, because bottle flipping is awesome, hashtag bottle flip
But
challenge.
Most of all, it's fun and challenging, and I bet they actually think this is a good idea. So they want $17,000 for their initial run, mm-hmm. and they've gotten
$623. $623, all right. Justin.
Now, these rapscallions that put together this stuff, they've put funded campaigns in here. I think this might be.
Oh, you're saying you think this is our team messing with us with a ringer in there? Something that looks so dumb.
I think this is a shitty Kickstarter. Not all shitty Kickstarters are failed Kickstarters.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, wait, Bryce, are they all failed?
They are not all failed.
I say that this hit its goal. This funded for $10,000.
How much do you think it ended up? Or you thought it got 10,000?
I think it got 10,000.
What did it ask
no,
for?
They were raising 10. They got 12.
Okay, raising 10, and they got 12. This is the Rev Bottle Pro Bottle Flipping Kickstarter. It was actually canceled.
Oh!
After earning $32 of their $300 goal.
Oh, no!
Wow!
Because guess what? They're just fucking bottles, guys. all right, so that means that Justin was closer on the ask.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Brian was closer on the get. So
we're at 4-2.
4-2, that's right. All right. Mm. Well, let's get oh, here we go. This is the Nintendo Switch dog tongue stickers for Joy-Con.
I'm sorry.
The part, the what, the who, the what now?
Sure.
Don't make me wake Otfi. He's finally gone to sleep.
This is the Nintendo Switch, the new Nintendo Switch game console. Mm. Dog tongue stickers for Joy-Con. It's a a die-cut sticker that you put on the Joy-Con controller here. Because it kind of looks like a dog.
It does kind of already look like a dog, and this completes this. This is like those stickers that you could put on the back of the iPad that would take the Apple logo and make it look like the center of Iron Man's chest or whatever.
Sure.
Where it's like it took something that already kind of half looked like a thing and then finishes it.
Yeah. So...
by the way, Curtis LaRock just shouted, "Shut up and take my money!" Which might be an important clue.
I mean, listen, there's, you know, the Switches are finally hitting people's hands now, right? Like, are they actually shipping?
They
or?
Come out in a week.
In a week. So people are pumped, man. Like, Switch fever is about to sweep the nation, nay the world. So, I would say this tried to raise $500 and they have $600.
I think it's closer to $15, and I bet it double funded at I'll be conservative and say $2,000.
$2,000, God.
Yeah.
All right, guys, this is the Nintendo Switch dog tongue stickers for Joy-Con. They asked for $1,000 and received $7,098.
Wow! I think Brushwood gets both, right?
You said $300 or something, right?
You said that they would.
Oh, I said $5. Yeah. Oh, so maybe I get the ask.
Yeah, you get the goal.
Wait, I said $15 though, so it's equidistant. If it was,
Brian, you said $1,500. Justin
said $500, oh. And it was $1,000, right?
Never mind. Oh no, I thought you said $15,000. Oh, never mind. Yeah,
that's a draw.
Oh, you got it.
That's a draw on that.
Yeah.
And then Brian, you got the get. So good job, guys.
So wait, where are we at right now?
Right now we're at 3-4.
Yeah, 1 point difference.
Brian's got 3. Justin's got 4.
How many more of these we got?
Oh, we got some more.
Here we come. Otfi, he's getting competitive again. He's...
Well, have you told him it doesn't make the game fun if it's serious? Have you told him that yet?
I'll try to intimate that kind of between the lines as we do the game.
Just say... Here's what I would do. You just scream out loud, "It's not fun if you're competitive."
Okay.
To no one in particular.
Okay. All right. I'll
try it now.
I'll try that later, Otfi.
Ryan.
Otfi, sometimes you give bad advice. I love you. Good night. Good night, Otfi.
I wasn't going to sleep, if that's what you're thinking.
Why do you have the coffee, Otfi? Can I ask why you have the
coffee? Or I wasn't.
Oh, okay.
Now I am. Bryce, is there anything I can do for you, Bryce?
No, thank you so much, Otfi. That's really sweet. I'm actually doing really okay right now.
You sure?
I'm doing great. Thank you. Thank you, though.
Do you want a little warm milk?
A little warm milk sounds really nice. If you're not busy, could I just get just like a...
I mean, I'll just come on down, you put the milk in the cup and then you heat it up and then you bring it to the little Bryce because he loves it so much, he does. There you go, Bryce, it's your warm milk.
You.
I'm just going to go to sleep. It's no big deal. I've just been ready to go to sleep for about an hour now. It's not a big deal. Everybody calm down. At least just a bit of a night owl sometimes. Pins and needles trying to sleep in this coffin. I'm undead, by the way. I'm going to go to sleep now, though, before I forget everything. Bye.
Okay, good night, Otfi. Good night, Otfi. Oh,
gosh. Bryce, that sounded so sincere. I wanted to hop up and get you some warm milk.
All right.
Don't worry, Bonnie. I got it. I already got it. You don't need to get it.
No, Otfi, really, this is too much. I mean, it's just, by the
you
way,
should
you can
go
tell
to bed for the night. Right, it's so now. Late, Otfi.
The audience is turning on us. They're like, would you just fucking let Otfi sleep?
It's no problem, chat room. I'm literally just sitting here awake. I was about to go to sleep, but now I'm not. I'm not asleep now. It's not a big deal.
All right. Good night. Good night.
Good night, Otfi.
Good night.
All right. I'm going to show you I'm going to show you something. I'm going to explain what it is here. This is, well, I want to create an American version of a Doctor Who pilot episode to send to BBC and put on YouTube.
Oh my God.
So can you describe the gentleman that we're looking at in this?
This is his first high school headshots.
This is, if I'm not mistaken, the 2006 winner of the junior close-up competition at the Kentucky State Magic Association Showdown, Western World Showdown.
Yeah. Curtis LaRock says, wait, do you mean aside from Brian's next assistant?
He's thin enough and half white.
Exactly. Would you like me to call Julio Manuel Pomajero Jr., Brian?
No, Offie, I swear. All right. Oh.
I have a bachelor's.
He's a little thick in the middle. Bye.
And I would like to be your next Doctor Who.
So this is, oh boy. He wants to bring a fresh new twist to the Doctor Who series.
Hold on.
I wonder who he got to do the video.
Look at the programs he used. He used 3D Max.
Sure.
It's
3DS Max, but okay.
He used Affect Effect.
Right.
Oh, that's my favorite.
He used misspelled Premiere Pro.
That's Premiere.
Premiere Pro.
Premiere Pro. That's actually how they
Photoshop.
Pronounce it in France.
And Photoshop. He wants to bring a fresh new Doctor Who series that will reverberate through your mind for years to come. I will listen to all input and guidance from the audience. The participation will be the motivation I need to interact with my consumers. I am pitching you my creativity because it will add value to the show, and that's what makes content so great.
Okay. Somewhere out there is the Leonardo da Vinci of writing the perfect shitty Kickstarter.
The target markets I'm after is the teen female market and the Hispanic and Caucasians market. Their motivation is cool and amazing things that broaden their imaginations and fill them with confidence.
This is a joke from beginning to end.
The females love beautiful scenes with drama and passion.
There is zero chance this is remotely real. He asked
Brian, this is what we have told.
Look at that font.
None of this is in plain text, by the way. This is all embedded into JPEGs. Of this crappy pitch doc.
Wait.
Brian,
is this
hold
from...
on? The U.S. Census Bureau has a chart in this thing. What does this say on there?
The U.S. Census Bureau sees racial, ethnic demographic shift away from whites into people of color.
U.S. teens' most important social network
Facebook is trending down. Instagram is trending up. This was also 2014. So.
Okay.
You don't think that this is like really annoying guy who's like in high school? You don't think it's that?
Could be, and that's certainly the kind of guy who would want a Kickstarter so he could make an episode to send to the BBC and I guess also YouTube. But it is so like okay. A stopped clock is right twice a day. I feel like if this was real.
Now clock is right forever.
Here we have some merchandise.
He's got merchandise body.
This is a jigsaw puzzle with him. Half of his photos on here. This is all like model photos of him in like a tank top, and doing this like aw shucks
too
thing with
perfect.
His hand.
Too
well,
perfect's
not the right
like,
word for it.
No, by which I mean it is a perfect failure. Close your eyes, point your finger on a thing, and that word is misspelled or a joke is funny. Like, there's literally not one part of this that's clearly a joke.
Have you met a high school student in a while? I don't know.
Yeah, man. I feel like this has a whiff of like overactive. No, he doesn't want to give somebody access to it or show it because he's kind of ashamed, like, and so that's where the misspellings are there.
I'll say this is his second Kickstarter project.
Ooh.
Well,
That is interesting.
Kickstarter.
Can we know his first?
Kickstarter as a comedy venture. Like this, like, I think okay. This is the Chuck Tingle of Kickstarter.
I won't tell you how it went, but his first Kickstarter was called The Jolt. Description, I'm a 3D artist, period. The goal I'm after is reporting the wins of games with awesome graphics one a week and making cool work for my reels.
This is absolutely real. That is real, and this one's real. 100%.
He's the Chuck Tingle of Kickstarter. He's post-ironic to the max, and it's all fake. I'm going to say 10 grand, and he got $38. Yep. Is it my turn to go first?
I believe so.
Okay.
So a 10K ask and a $38 get, right?
Yeah.
All right, Justin.
I am going to say he asked for $15,000, and he got the goose.
Zero. You took the under on $38 funded in the butt by my own butt.
All right. Well,
oh, my gosh.
Now we do have to I feel confident in my ruling, but I do want to put the asterisk, the potential. This is still an active project. There are 49 hours left to go.
It's not too late, people.
Well,
$38.
For this game it is.
If you want me to be right.
He asked for $200,000.
Oh,
that's Justin.
Jesus. Oh, my
and
God.
Received $57. That's Brian.
Wow.
Another split one, guys. Good job.
There's no chance. There's zero chance. Where can we find that Kickstarter?
Kickstarter.com.
No, I mean,
oh, he's got page one at the bottom of his infographic.
That's right. This is very clearly like a pitch document that he made at one point. This is just
he's got quotes. Look at the quotes, Bryce. Look at the quotes.
So good.
He's got quotes.
Logic will get you from A to B. Imagination will take you everywhere. Albert
said
Einstein.
By who?
Albert
That's
Einstein.
Not true. That's not a real quote.
This is a dude peacocking.
This is him doing.
That's not. Wait, who said that?
He said that he said it was that Albert Einstein said that, and that's not true.
I mean, look at this poster. Put that face on your wall, teenage girls.
You should, man. Dude, I'll tell you what. They're just getting... There's really no word I can say about
benefits?
Teenage girl excitement that's not going to be creepy.
No. Okay, it's spelled correctly.
Benefits is one of the correctly spelled words on the page.
Sorry.
Alrighty. Oh, my goodness.
That's a gem, man. That is a diamond.
That's a good find. Good find.
All right, I'm gonna play you guys a video. I want you to tell me when you think you got an idea of what this product is. All right. Give me one sec for it to load. Hit the button. Go to the right place. Do.
Oh, is there a phone number?
We're not giving out this kid's.
No,
call
no,
him right now.
No.
I mean, we could call him. Though.
At Unruled, we believe that you should be able to find what works for you.
All right, pause.
You should be able to forge a.
That jaunty music, is it so on the nose now that it's poison, or is it still functional? Like Helvetica, and will be with us forever.
Oh, I think it's functional.
Jaunty mandolin.
Yeah, no, the strummy, like, yeah. You know, as long as you have this kind of video in front of it, then it's like, yeah, maybe it's an ad for, like, blood pressure, maybe it's a Kleenex,
yeah, right?
I don't know, but I'm happy about it.
All right.
Lifestyle that allows you to thrive.
Just tell me when you think you know
what it
is.
Without being constrained to existing structures. Our notebook is designed for creatives
what
and intellectuals alike. It provides an open canvas for your mind, free of distractions.
Is the product a fucking spiral notebook?
Absolutely it is, Brian. Absolutely.
Oh, yeah. Students are constantly bombarded with new information. Every day we are presented with complex concepts that we are expected to fit between thin blue lines. We accept these lines as part of the note-taking process, but it doesn't have to be that way. A new notebook is born. We created a product that puts the user first, allowing students to bring their thoughts to life.
Oh, my God.
We took the best features from traditional notebooks and improved the rest. Unruled.
Unruled.
Oh, my God.
Totally real. Totally real. $10,000, and it's got $3,000. Wait, I'm not supposed to go first.
No, he's not starting. Justin, tell me about Unruled.
I am going to go 11,000. And I'm going to say that it got... Oh, they look so young.
Archfey! Archfey, do you still have...
Yes, yes, Master Brushwood. You're so lucky you got me before I went to sleep. I thought for a second that it was you in a dream.
No.
Wasn't sleeping, though. I was awake.
Okay, good.
What do you need from me? I've lived to serve. Just kidding. I'm undead.
Where did I leave my millennial stick?
Oh, the millennial stick. Well, that would be right below the dog's leash and the taser for the olds.
No, that's a baseball bat. I wanted the one with the spiky barbs on it.
Oh, your barbed millennial stick.
Yes, the
right.
Barbed
that's
millennial
for the
stick.
Ovaltine, you silly goose.
Okay, thank you. Appreciate it. Good night.
Would you like me to get it?
No.
Would you like me to just run down? I can run down real quick. You know what? I can get it. I'm not asleep if you thought I was asleep. I sleep in a coffin in your attic, but I wasn't asleep yet. I'm still awake. I can run down and get your Bob Millennial stick. It's not a problem.
No, it's fine.
Are you sure?
Set a reminder for me to get it oiled tomorrow, would you?
Let me put it in my unruled notebook.
No!
Good night, Archie.
I swear, Bonnie, remind me to tell Otfi to buy us a barbed millennial stick.
Oh, have him.
It's still, I can just get it now. I'm just going to go get it now. I'm just going to walk down. I'm walking downstairs. It's no bother.
Well, if you're going to go do it right.
Millennial stick got used to assault the kids, and you give it to Brian Brushwood.
Barbed millennial
stick. Anyway, there you go. It's no problem. I'm just going to go back. Well, I'm going to go to sleep now. Well, I mean, my eyes, just how tired do they look? I'm just walking back upstairs. I'm just going to go. I'm going to go to sleep. If anybody needs anything, it's not a problem. I'm here, but I'll probably be asleep. Just be aware I will, okay?
Okay, good night.
Okay,
good night, Archie.
I'm climbing in now.
No, we're good. Thank you. Good night, Archie.
Okay.
Got my barbed millennial stick.
One of the frequently asked questions, how is the Unruled notebook different from a typical sketchbook? Unruled is built around the visual note-taking experience. Sketchbooks are currently frustrating note-takers with their higher prices, thicker paper, and non-standard sizes. Our product takes the simplicity of a standard spiral notebook and tailors it to meet the needs.
Swear to God, I'm going to actually build a barbed millennial stick if I have to hear another word about this.
Well, Justin, you're up first. You said an $11,000 ask.
I said $11,000, and I think that they have rich parents, and they have $9,000 of that.
I'm going to say both are lower. It's I'll go $10,000, and they've gotten $3,000.
$3,000. Okay. All right. This is Unruled, a sustainable notebook for creative thinkers. They've earned $2,467.
Oh,
out of a $6,000 goal. Those
double prizes!
Both
wow.
For Brushwood.
You nailed it.
You nailed
yeah.
It. All right, now it is 6-4. Welcome to the...
I'm sorry, just real... I don't...
Oh, by the way, they're going to fund, by the way.
Yeah, they have 27 days. They might get this.
Can we just press pause and just, like, this is the real world, and this is the world.
I mean, like, you know what this is. I mean, this is a bunch of outgoing kids that, like, want to set up a thing. This is their first step into, like, entrepreneurism. And for one reason or another, either one of their dads owns a paper mill or they went online and they went to, like, Chinese notebook, you know, place. And they figured that they could buy
one. Chinese notebook distillery where they –
distillery for notebooks.
Yes, where they distill.
This has college prod –
Project written
all
over
it.
Yeah,
this is what they're doing now.
Oh, my gosh. Wow. Dude, you guys are going to like this week's pig.
It's a little pig? Weird.
Yeah. No, pig. It looks almost like a manatee. Can we?
A manatee. He's not done yet, as Ben Lang.
Bonnie is sculpting a pig for people who have no idea what that sentence means.
Yeah, including the co-host.
All right, this is the special triple round. I'm going to show you a video.
All right, well, here. Right now, Brian, let's just agree, sudden death, right? Whoever goes up
Yeah, I think it's a one-point game anyway. So this is the million-point challenge quarter hour land.
It's an hour of it. I'm gonna play you this video, and I just want you to tell me when you think you know what this product is.
Okay. Okay.
All right. Here we go.
Stop. This is a thing for ladies to pee in.
Okay. Justin, what do you think? Oh.
Yeah. God damn it.
This is the Emmer jug.
Emmer jug. Like emergency. Yeah.
That's right. It has.
Wow, dude. You had this one. Like.
So. Oh
I mean, I believe this is an already available medical device that they use for bedridden people. Like that's why I recognized it upon sight.
It's a bedpan, right?
It is a urinal receptacle. It comes in some fun colors, the Emmer jug, of course. It's hard plastic, it's got a mounting bracket, and it has a male and female option for the rubber bit where you put your donger in.
Okay.
Man, that seems a lot more expensive than just buying a 2-gallon thing of water, drinking it, and then peeing.
And here's what it is, I would hope if they did their homework, they're like, we're fully HP HVAC certified and love. Yeah.
And you get HPV. That's not a bonus in my book.
Good night, OP.
I was not asleep, if that's sorry. I don't want to be a third. I don't want to be a fourth mic. So don't worry about me. I just wanted to jump in.
That's fine.
Good.
That's
contribution.
Fine.
Okay.
Yeah, I guarantee
I'm going
you
to sleep.
They have some kind of certification, they're charging like $30 a pop.
Well, so since this is the final round, I'm gonna ask you guys for three things. I'm gonna ask you what they were asking.
Yep.
What they've gotten. And the cost of this, the regular cost, not an early bird cost.
Regular cost is going to be $39.99. They are asking for $30,000, and they are almost funded.
I'm going to need a number on that.
$22,000.
All right, Justin. The Emmer jug.
I think that the Emmer jug.
When you gotta go, you gotta go.
Early prices for. Do they have a yellow one?
Let me see. I don't.
No, they have. They only have golden.
That's no, the they distinctly thing. Don't have a yellow one.
Yeah, they very yeah. specifically. They do have a one that is much clearer to see through than the others.
Yeah, why not go solid on that?
Go with solid, I guess, color.
Yeah, question. All right. I think that the early bird price on it
not early bird,
regular
retail. Retail
on it will be $60.
Okay.
I think that they are asking for $60,000.
Okay.
And I think that they have gotten $5,000.
$5,000. All right, guys. The Emmer jug asked for $32,000.
That is
Brian almost on the nose saying $30,000. So that's a point to him. They've gotten $909. That's a point for Justin.
Okay.
Yeah, because I went low.
I went low. And the price of a retail Emmer jug is $20.
Oh!
Got it!
I got 1,000,000 points!
Damn it!
That's right. Congratulations, Brian!
Otfi, I won! I won the game!
Oh, I'm so sorry! I was about to sleep, but I think that I heard you win! That's great!
I did!
Would you like me to make you a trophy?
Yes. I mean, now that you mention it.
I can whittle a little trophy together. I've got my knife. I can just go ahead and whittle it out of wood if you'd like.
It would be nice to commemorate the win, Arfie. I'm just saying.
To commemorate the win. Just a little memento. You can put it on your dash, maybe, or in your study.
See if you can also add a safety pin. Maybe I can wear it from time to time.
You
Good night,
wear
Arfie.
Wear it on your shirt. That's a great idea. I'm going to do it right now. You whittle up the trophy and you give it to him so he feels proud all day. Proud all day. Here you go, Master Brushwood. It's a trophy with a safety pin on it. You can wear it on your shirt. By the way, that looks dirty. Throw it in the hamper. I'll get to it tomorrow. Anyway, I'm Oddfee. I'm going to sleep.
Good
Don't
night,
worry
Oddfee.
About me. I sleep in a coffin. I'm undead. It's a weird situation, but don't just go with it. Anyway, I'm going to sleep now.
Good night, Oddfee.
I look like the Crypt Keeper. Also undead. But I look younger
yes,
for some reason.
We don't know.
That's life. Anyway, I'm going to sleep now, okay?
Good night,
Arfie. Right, I'm going.
Good night.
I'm going to sleep.
By the way, an update on the straw poll.
Bonnie, remind me to buy some coffin oil just so we can clear that out.
Well, you know, he's going to the store tomorrow.
Okay, well, I'll remember to tell him tomorrow. He might be sleeping.
Rick, I'm not. I wasn't.
God damn it.
I wasn't asleep. Do you need anything?
Good night.
All right.
Okay.
I kind of think the bit's gone on too long, but you know, if you need anything, then I'm here.
You should just go to sleep for the night, I think.
I should go to sleep with it. I was literally half past snooze town, and I had to come back because I heard that there was a need.
No, we're fine. Good night, Oppie. Hey, let's check in on the Movie Draft Minute.
Welcome to Movie Draft Minute, presented by CosmicRadio.tv for the week of February 27th, 2017. I'm your host, Roberto Villegas. Man, it's been a weird week for film. Bill Paxton's death, Oscar mishaps. But hey, look on the bright side. Zootopia won an Oscar. Yay! Anywho, let's go check the scoreboard, see how our competitors are doing. Chrissy Cates is in sixth place with $293.3 million. Mikey Newman's in fifth place with $302.8 million. Milongo A.E. is in fourth place with $399.7 million. Josh Robert Young's in third place with $482.7 million. Team DTNS is in second place with Collide bringing in $1.5 million, bringing their total to $711 million. And in first place, the whopping $763.4 million, it's Brian Brushwood. And that is your Movie Draft Minute for the week of February 27th, 2017.
So this is the week we find out whether or not Logan has those, has them legs.
Yeah, dude. I mean, I feel like we said everything there is to say about it. What we really need to do is start figuring out like what the teams are going to be. Have we heard back for the summer movie draft?
Not quite, but we are looking at the Monday after the South by show. I think that is March 13 as doing the summer movie draft. So we having a little bit of overlap between these two drafts.
Oh, that's right. One will play out.
Wait, the Monday? We're going to do it on Court Killers?
Summer is a Court Killers, right?
Winter is Court Killers. Summer is Night Attack.
So then that would be, if Night Attack.
It would be the week after we do the South by show.
Oh, so that would be the 21st.
Yeah.
Tuesday the 21st. Hmm. We'll keep an eye out.
That's an interesting.
Because that gives us a little bit more time to
Yeah.
To study up. Together. So, okay. So we talked about invitations. We're going to invite Frog Pants people.
ITV says, do you guys need jingles? Hell yeah.
Oh,
Mike
damn. Absolutely. Oh, damn. You get over there with that fat ass guitar. and then you teach Offie how to play it, because we definitely need jingles.
What?
No.
Okay. Don't wake him up again.
No. Since college. Do you need a funky bass line?
It's like worse. It's worse than saying.
Do you need a funky bass line? Hold on. Let me just lay one down for you.
It's worse than actually saying Voldemort, because unlike saying Voldemort, it does summon the person.
All right, thank you for the funky bass line, Audrey. Good night.
Okay, everyone's tired of me. I can tell it. I'm undead. I've lived a long time.
Audrey, don't be that way. All right, hey, Audrey, come here.
It's fine. I'm Audrey.
Come here.
No one thinks Audrey about the feelings of Audrey, after all. He's just the undead manservant.
Give him a... Apologize, Brian. You woke him up, and he wasn't even needed.
Audrey, you know what I feel like? I need is a hug. Come here. Come here. Come on, Offie.
I just grip him by the waist and show them why I think he's the best, and it's a hug to Master Brushwood, and I will go off to sleep. Offie was a great character, and then he wore out his welcome because the fit went on too long and the screeching
didn't work. Good night, Offie. Good night. Good night.
Okay.
Meanwhile, Diamond Time is your chance to get
Diamond
your
Time
projects.
Is where you can shout out.
We have a movie poster for Brian Brushwood.
Why did you see this new movie coming out?
The Fifth Slipper.
The Fifth Slipper.
Look at you. This almost looks like a DreamWorks movie with that face.
It's pretty good. Pretty good.
Diamond Dime, of course, is where you can shout out your projects right here on the show. Just go on over to our Reddit, diamondclub.reddit.com or reddit.com/r/diamondclub if you would like to be a part of it. We start off with a Dentalian or Thomas Jefferson in the chat. Good evening, Diamond Club. Thomas Jefferson back checking in. Thank you for the shout out back in December. We are very grateful, but we are still in waiting. Hopefully it's okay to throw my hat back into the ring for some Diamond Time help. Here's the thing about adoption. There's a huge, long waiting game that sucks. You never know exactly how long it'll be. Sure, traditional parents have to wait about 9 months, and in the meantime, they get to watch this parasitic creature grow. Maybe. Adoptive parents to be.
Why do you suppose he's using a pseudonym to ask for our help?
We have the long indefinite wait, and then at a moment's notice, you get a phone call and be on a plane within 24 hours to who knows where. Then when we get it back here, it could just be more waiting, or you could be an instant parent. Also, on top of that, throw in a bunch of legal proceedings that have the potential to take away the newest person on earth that you now love more than yourself. That's adoption in a nutshell. Only thing we can help to speed up the process is to get our name out there and bit.ly/Braden and Andrea. Lowercase also works. bit.ly/Braden and Andrea. Whatever social media you can throw at that link would be very much appreciated from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you.
Oh, dude, I'm so glad that they checked back in on this. I really, really want this to happen. That's BRADENANDREA. So you could say Braden and Andrea, or you could say Braden and Rhea. But you probably shouldn't. You should probably use their actual names.
Use their names. That might help. Andrea. Yeah.
Meanwhile, Ms. Marvel Medusa says, hello, fellow Diamond Clubbers. My fellow co-founders and I just released our first book, The Retroactivist, through Space Boy Books, our science fiction publisher. I know how much everyone loves sci-fi here, so I think y'all would enjoy exploring various worlds and fascinating races. It's 2087. Mankind has eradicated war, poverty, and jobs. Robots now perform all work. Humans live free and strive for pure happiness and aesthetic perfection. Everyone except for Reed Rosales, unhappy with joy, unfulfilled by satisfaction, in the throes of a creative slump, Reed longs for something, anything, to help him rise above the easy pleasures of humanity's perfected society. Reed thinks he's the only one until he stumbles on to Club 20C, a 20th century nostalgia club. What he finds there, well, I don't want to spoil everything. The Retroactivist is up on Amazon, both ebook and paper form, and would love for Diamond Club to read and review it. Check us out, and hey, while you're at it, submit a story at readspaceboy.com. That's R-E-A-D, spaceboy. Clickable link is clickable.
Boom. And finally, Sam May says, what up, nerds? You familiar with D&D? Of course you are. Do you want to start DMing your own group? Of course you do. Do you want to be a group of internet strangers to allow you to DM their game for a season or two, then give you feedback on how you can improve? Then join the new DM Bootcamp face group I created. That is yolo420.com/@fee/can I have a beer slash or tinyurl.com/yolo420-d20swag. You can get all the info on our group, including how to join the adventuring party if you're interested. Experience DMs only, please. Can't give an advice if you don't know what the F you're doing.
Hot damn. Oh, also, I got a copy of Pilot X from Tom Merritt this week. I don't read books. I only do audiobooks, but, I may have, found a few minutes to go through the first chapter or three.
Mm-hmm.
I'm excited. Great, I'm super stoked about it.
Yeah, that comes out, in what, 2 weeks?
Yeah.
About 2 weeks?
Yeah.
Who did that cover?
Oh, it's beautiful.
Is that a Len Peralta joint?
No, this is one that came, if I remember correctly, Tom referenced it on Chord Killers. He was saying that, it's a number 6 bestseller in science fiction on Inkshares. I think it was from Inkshares. Like they had one of their artists.
Design team. Yeah.
Dude, it looks great. Looks amazing, huh?
Yeah. Apparently, like the design came about pretty quick, and then there's a lot of color. Yeah.
A lot of color was the sticking point.
Like, oh, how autumnal do we want this to look?
Well, hell, Brian, man, what do we learn?
We learn that characters are like rain. They fall from the skies, they cloud our minds, and they make us cold and alone.
We've learned that Brian likes bacon, and Bryce likes more milk.
We learned, unfortunately, that we don't have to prepare very much for the show. We just kind of show up.
Precedent. This is a bad precedent.
See what happens, and then it's amazing.
We've learned that notebooks have indeed been reinvented.
Man, most of all, we've learned that we just can't quit you, Chat Realm. We love you with all our hearts. You guys changed our lives. We owe you everything. We'll see you next Tuesday.
Die in a friendship.
I get so sad. I like that.
That I wanna drink a warm glass of Drano.
Otfi, fetch me the Drano.
You got it.
Night attack. 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 I love you.
Diamond Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.